Okay. Escape from Basingstoke. Now, what can I say? This is all born about through an article on the Register about Linux gaming. So there were a few games creators quoted in the article. And among them was Caspian Prince, and he was one of the co-founders of Puppy Games, and this is one of their games, Escape from Basingstoke. Now, there's also Bearded Giant, and there's a lot of discussion about Linux gaming, in particular linked to breaking away from the mainstream. And yeah, long story short, is this cost about £21 to have the executable on Humble Bundle, and I decided to go for that rather than Steam, so that I had the executable so I could run it on whatever the hell I liked. And here we are. I've had a very brief play of it, so yeah. There's a warning about flashing lights, so you can actually reduce the flashing if you wish. Comedy gore, you can reduce the gore if you like. And apocalyptic Basingstoke can be a scary place and may not be suitable for small children or those of a nervous disposition. There are those who would argue that Basingstoke is not as it is a scary place and not suitable for children even before it's apocalyptic, but I'm not going to go there. Puppy Games, welcome to Basingstoke. We've gone through some options, including the game, instant death penalty. These are the defaults. Okay, so there's a you can take photos. Graphics I've upped a little, so we've gone for high quality graphics, full vertical sync, and we're gonna tone down the music. Master volume, we're gonna keep a little up, and that's about it. Keyboard, we have a number of things. The WASD keys. Fire use being the left. You can move using the right button. Sneak is shift. Crafting is Q. Torch is confirm is space return or F. Reload is R. Oh, so we're going to get some weapons in here. Okay, this is probably going to be difficult to remember, but hey ho. Now, apparently there are a number of other avatars, but I don't think that we've actually got any of these unlocked. So we're stuck with the office worker. We'll play with Frida, no bonus items. Nobody's got any bonus items. Okay. So we shall continue. Level 2 hard. Replay previous levels to add more items to your campsite stash. Okay, so we can replay previous levels. Okay. So this is the job interview. Going up or down on the mouse immediately brings up the encyclopedia, which we will do away with. The first thing that I find myself looking to do is want to zoom out, but I don't think I've got that option. So we try and go out. No, we can't. We're stuck here. Hello. Hello. Blah 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 blah. Please take a minute to press. I didn't press anything, we just picked that up. Take the lift to third floor. Now this is important. So we've got the sandwiches. This is important. Blah, 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 blah. So we can now use the scroll to select these. Blah, 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 blah. And I can throw a sandwich. Blah, 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 blah. Ooh, they love sandwiches. So I'm throwing the sandwiches at specific locations. I like to play hide and seek with them. We're getting out of here. So we can't really go anywhere other than onwards. I can hold the right mouse button to move in that area. That lift is out of order. We've got to go into this one. Oh dear. We're going down. We're going down to level minus 9. Are you sure that was in the manual? Hazmat, if there are no seats available, please report to control. All seats are in use. Decontamination area. Okay. We've got to go to the decontamination area. No choice. Whereupon, things go rather wrong. Just a bit. Oh dear. That doesn't sound good. That's not looking very good at all. Oh dear. I don't think we actually have any health indicators. We've got to go that way, but it's too dark, so we can't do it. Let's have a bit more of a look around here. Nothing. Okay, we've got lighting. Ouch.
Blah 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 bl
Oh, we picked up some sausage rolls. Note that those guys were actually highlighted in white. These two are behind us, so I'm giving it grief. So anyone who's in white, we're all going to die. Oh, very positive. So you see some of them. There's more sausage rolls. We'll select the sausage rolls. I don't care that we're all going to die. What do you think? Pick up a sausage roll. Come on, if you're going to follow me. You're going to follow me or not? Oh, come on, any minute. Right, we're going to have to throw one of these. Oh dear. Sausage roll or none, I think they're buggered. Because we ain't getting back there. We're going to follow the green arrows. Hello, do you want to tag along? How the hell should I know? It looks like green arrows are giving us the direction to go. But we'll need a key card. Oh, we've got a door unlock code. So simply running into these guys or something. I don't like all this vibration stuff. You've got a good feeling. I'm dead. He may have a good feeling about it, but I'm feeling pretty pissed. Okay, so we're back here. Well, this isn't very helpful. Okay, looks like we made it through that. Welcome to Basingstoke. Okay. Controls, map, tab. So there's a map, is there? You are here. Find the key and get to the pub. Spray? Use change. Huh? Wheelie bin, tab for end of here. Tap, tap to exit. Disposable weapon. Part of 3 crafting recipes. Zombie police guy. Found a postcard. Visit Sunny Basingstoke. Oh my god. The red line is that way. Oh, we got the pub key. Site. Select items from the stash to take with me. Okay. If an object has never been highlighted, you can't search for it for loot. You can't search it for loot. That makes no sense. £5 and a penny. Thank you. That made no sense. Okay. Sausage rolls, do we have? Just the one by the side of it. Fat wallet, 10 pence and 3 pence. Silently smashable. We're dead. I'm starting to get a bit cheesed off with this. This ain't good. This ain't easy. I think I'm leaning to directing with the mouse rather than anything else. No pool table this time. Oh crap. Insurance policy, 15 quid. How do we buy? Okay, we now have a kebab. Shit. Wrong button. So we're searching for the key and I can't find it. Thank you. requires batteries. So where the heck is this key? Love this. Station. Crafting recipes. Sounds alarm is smashed. Can control contain loot and crowbars open silently. We don't have a crowbar. Tentacle can't move. Weak to fire. May hide an ambush. Sometimes has loot. Prowler kills you in one hit, slow moving, weak, often hunts in packs, weaker from behind and sometimes has loot. Where is our objective? Up there, so we have to get out of here and turn left. Police station. Is added to the campsite stash. That was interesting. It was interesting. Was it worth £21? I don't know. I suppose I could do with some more information as to these recipes and how I'm supposed to make things and what I can learn and what I can do. Because, I need a bit more of a tutorial, so I'll definitely be looking at that. Before I come back to this, it's good that it actually just chucks you back to the campsite, which is a very good good method of save game, of checkpoint, which is interesting. The other interesting thing is that this build of the game 101 was built in April 2018, so this is a couple of years old. So I'm hoping that there should be very little in the way of bugs in this now. This should be a well-formed game. And I'm glad about that. I'm happy for that. It's not looking easy. How deep the game is, I don't know. But it's new. It's fun. It's quirky. I wish there was a bit more of a tutorial about making things. Definitely it helps to have your flashlight off. But it makes it more difficult for... more difficult to see what the hell you're doing. And the map is pretty much critical. However, having the flashlight on is necessary to find things. Other than that laser pointer, by the looks of it. So that's going to be interesting. And, no guarantees of anything. So I'm going to bid you adieu for this video. And, I'll catch you later. And, let's see what else is available for Linux. Let's see what else Puppy Games has got. I think there is another Humble Bundle with all of their earlier games, and this seems to be the latest. And that's a couple of years old. So, we've got to see what happens. In the hoo-ha bar, I will put the link to the Register article that was discussing Puppy Games and also Bearded Giant. Now, Bearded Giant's website is currently in maintenance, and that's because I think Bearded Giant has decided to come off Steam and other commercial platforms and go direct sales only. And that's where it looks like Bearded Games is heading. Hence, the website is under maintenance, which makes sense. But I'm going to keep an eye, and I'm going to leave you with this, and I'll catch you on the next video. Until then, chaff and owl.